Mum and Dad and Denny saw the passing out parade, Pakapanum. It was a long march from cadets, and the 6th Battalion was the next to tour. It was me who drew the card. We did Canungra and Shoalwater before we left. And Townsville lined the footpaths as we marched down to the quay. This clipping from the paper shows us young and strong and clean. And there's me in me slouch hat with me SLR and greens. God help me, I was only 19. From Vruntel, Pride and Chinooks to the dust at Newey Dat, I'd been in and out of choppers now for months. And we made our tents a home, VB and pin-ups on the lockers, and an Asian orange sunset through the scrub. And can you tell me, doctor, why I still can't get to sleep? Night time's just a jungle dark and a barking M16. What's this rash that comes and goes? Can you tell me what it means? God help me.
Remembrance Day. I've met Paul here, who served in Vietnam, and Paul's going to tell us a little bit about his story. Paul, lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Tony.
And, can you tell us a bit about yourself?
Commando SAS. SAS is a special forces, and we're sworn to secrecy, so I can't tell you a lot. I was over in Newey Dat, Long Tan, and Quavasi Province, and I served 18 months over there. We were only supposed to be there for 6 months, and then did 13 tasks. We were told on the 12th task that we were only bugging out, and it hit the fan, and we end up with Black 13, and we're all really weren't real happy about doing that 13th tour, tasks. So yeah, I'm glad to be an ex-serviceman, and I'm proud of my country.
Thank you for your service.
My pleasure. I think of all the other diggers that passed on, I wear my uniform with pride, and we can't do. I get a bit emotional, but a lot of memories come back, flooding back into the brain, and there's been a lot of hardship. I'm not proud. I tried to commit suicide 3 times because we didn't have the support that the diggers or the Afghanistan boys and that get now. We were treated like shit, if you don't mind the language. And we were rubbished when we came back. We weren't welcome. It's hard, but you learn to... Yeah, take it off.
When you first came back, I remember some of the troops were booed as they came off the ship.
Yes. Yeah.
And the RSL wouldn't let you go.
Wouldn't even let you go into the thing. Yeah. As I said, we were treated like garbage. And it was hard for us guys. We fought for our country. And, we didn't fight for our country. We fought for the South Vietnamese against the North Vietnamese, it was a conflict that we shouldn't have been involved, as far as I'm concerned. It was a politician war, and because the Americans went in, us being allies to the Americans, we had to go. And at 19 years of age, you can't wrap that around your brain. I'm proud. I'm a proud Australian, and always be a proud Australian until the day I die.
Thank you very much, Paul, for talking to us, and thank you very much for your service.
My pleasure.
Really appreciate it, mate.
Thanks very much.
Yeah.
Thank you.